amazing fans, the truth is, we are here for you. We got to thank you for 10 years of support and inspiration. You're the reason we're here.
Thank you for 10 years of
the greatest cosplay.
Standing in those long lines for Hall H.
Reading the comics after you saw the movie.
Twitter fights.
And it's all been leading up to this.
Thank you.
Thanks, guys.
Thank you so much.
Thanks for being so incredible.
We couldn't have done any of this without you.
Kennedy said, "I have a responsibility to the company that I work with. I don't feel that I have a responsibility to cater in some way to those particular fans. I would never just seize on saying, well, this is a franchise that's appealed primarily to men for many, many years, and therefore I owe men something."
It's going to be really exciting. I mean, I've seen a little bit of the clip that they're going to show, but you know, this is such a fan-driven enterprise and franchise, you could call it. That's a terrible one.
I've been a Marvel fan my entire life. I've worked for Marvel for over 10 years now. And during all of that time, it was, why can't all the characters come together like they do in the comics? And about 5 years ago, we became Marvel Studios. We had the rights to almost all of our great, great characters. And I realized, you know what, we could do it now. And we started doing little things like putting Sam Jackson at the back of Iron Man 1, bringing Black Widow into Iron Man 2, really bringing all these worlds together. And now finally it's here, and we're almost finished principal photography. And I have to pinch myself almost every day to realize we're actually making this movie.
People have just stayed with it. It means something to them.
Certainly at this point, to be working on something like Star Wars is the culmination of all the experience that I've had over the years that I've been able to put to use with this film. So, well, I didn't have to make a final call, really. It was a conversation I'd been able to have with George Lucas, and he came to me and said that he thought that perhaps we were ready to start making Star Wars again. And I immediately thought of, just from the standpoint of being somebody in the audience, that it would be so wonderful to have these stories come back. And
I've been a Marvel fan my entire life.
And I immediately thought of, just from the standpoint of being somebody in the audience.
I've worked for Marvel for over 10 years now.
Certainly at this point, to be working on something like Star Wars is the culmination of all the experience that I've had over the years that I've been able to put to use with this film, so.
And I have to pinch myself almost every day to realize we're actually making this movie.
Were you always a Star Wars fan?
I was a Star Wars fan in the fact that I had already decided to become a film major in college when the movie came out. And there's no question that it was a groundbreaking movie. And I think that that's something inside the company that I still find the most interesting, which is that George recognized that taking stories to drive technology was one of the most important things you could do. And that's something that we continue to do as we develop our stories. We keep looking at where can we start to push the technological boundaries to do more than we could have ever imagined.
Kevin Feige, when I first came, Kevin Feige is, runs the show. When I first came on set to do makeup tests for Vision, he kind of cried. he's a real fan.
I was a Star Wars fan in the fact that I had already decided to become a film major in college from the standpoint of being somebody in the audience.
I remember when you built that shed on top of your apartment building. I didn't even know if that was legal, but
yeah,
you built
me
that.
Neither. I didn't ask for a permit. What did I put in that shed?
Star Trek figures?
Toys.
Yeah.
Again, there's a lot of mystery about him, even within the film. So you have to fill in your your own backstory. I'm sure there'll be comic books and video games and novels that tell the story, but...
I'm just going to break in here and make sure that everybody out there realizes he is so significantly important to this next film. You have no idea.
Well, that's good to hear.
Mr. Modesty. From the standpoint of being somebody in the audience. People have just stayed with it. It means something to them. I was a Star Wars fan in the fact that I had already decided to become a film major in college.